Her persistence has paved the way for passage of some of the most important legislation in this generation, including guaranteed access to health care coverage for millions of previously uninsured Americans. But more than that, her achievements, Nancy Pelosi is the perfect candidate to speak to us because she embodies the grit and determination that makes us Spartans.
Okay.
She is the living example of the persistence that drove today's graduates to pursue the dreams of college degrees. Each of you is on a journey. As Pelosi's journey took her and her husband Paul from Baltimore to New York and to San Francisco, she has represented the citizens of California's 12 House districts for more than 27 years. Leader Pelosi has spearheaded historic investments in college aid, clean energy and innovation, initiatives to help small businesses and veterans, and she has been a powerful voice for civil rights and human rights all around the world. And now, it's my distinct honor and privilege to introduce to you this morning's Congressman, female speaker, Democratic leader, Nancy Pelosi.
Mr. Coach, a legendary coach and teacher, and what a wonderful, wonderful statement you made this morning. Thank you, Coach. To all of the distinguished board recipients recognized here today, congratulations and best wishes. Congratulations to California State University System, graduating with 3 million students this year. And thank you to the students, faculty, and leaders of San Jose State for your invitation for me to participate in this special gathering. It is an honor for me to share in your celebration. And let us all acknowledge once again, as the president did so beautifully earlier, the families and friends of graduates, parents and partners, siblings and spouses, grandparents and children, all whose love and encouragement have made this day a reality for today's graduates. And above all, to the graduates. As the president said, this is your day, your success, your achievement. The degrees you achieved today have been written in the tools of hard work, late nights, and juggled responsibilities. Your diplomas are not simply a recognition of completed coursework. They are fruit of your faith in yourselves. Testimonies to your drive, your determination, your grit, your dreams to build a better world for yourselves, your families, your communities, and our country. On behalf of the Congress of the United States, I am proud to bring deepest congratulations to you, the San Jose State University Class of 2015. In Congress, Congressman Mike Condon, a proud San Jose State Spartan himself, and Congresswoman Anna Heshey, one of your strong advocates. Each of them exemplifies the best of America, the American dream. Each of them are tireless champions of yours. Each of them are deeply invested that you are ensuring that you're able to achieve the American dream. As you graduate today, leave here knowing that you are graduating from one of the most vibrant universities in our nation. You are entering the ranks of more than 150 years of distinguished San Jose State and Spartans, and they are powering the future. Now, class of 2015, you are powering the future. You will make your own mark. And as you begin your journey, here is my message to you. Have confidence. Be proud. Be ready. Have confidence in your education. Be proud of your experience here. You are one of the most diverse classes anywhere in America. And I might add, 50% women. Have confidence and strength in that diversity. As I say with pride, the city of San Francisco, which I represent in Congress, the beauty is in the mix. It's true of San Francisco, it's true of this graduating class. Trust in the value of diverse and different perspectives as represented by your fellow graduates. Respect and cherish the diversity you have been blessed with here at San Jose State. Our founders had confidence in a principle they knew would have had to guide our nation. E pluribus unum. From many, one. The founders could never have imagined how vast our country would become, how diverse the many would be, ethnicities, nationalities, gender identities, beliefs, and priorities. They had a sense, though, that immigration would invigorate our nation. That's why we must pass a comprehensive immigration bill, and soon. And so long term is in the beginning from that. And they knew that we would have to be from many one. Our founder's wish is our command. Every day in classrooms and public events across the nation, we pledge allegiance to one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Liberty and justice for all is the beauty of America. This is the ideal our brave men and women in uniform risk and give their lives to defend every day. On this Memorial Day weekend, let us once again recognize the sacrifice and the service of our veterans, our men and women in uniform, and their families. And that for all of our differences of identity and ideas, we are committed to being one nation. Class of 2015, each of you, indeed all of us, has a role to play in honoring our diversity, in carrying out the vision and the values of from many, one, into the next generation. To do so, you should draw strength from the values that define your community and your university. You have a very special responsibility because you have had a special opportunity. San Jose State sits at the confluence of two great diverse American legacies, the humanity of Cesar Chavez and the ingenuity of Silicon Valley. It was not far from this stadium in East San Jose that Cesar Chavez started his own education. As Chavez wrote in his autobiography of La Casa, it was here that he first encountered the ideas and learned the skills that he and his friends would use to ignite the farm workers' rights movement, and to do so in a non-violent way. It was here that he started thinking about social justice, started to organize the community, started reading about the life of St. Francis of Assisi and the philosophy of Mahatma Gandhi. Today, the wisdom of his own legacy is written into the great Cesar Chavez left monument that graces this campus, which says the end of all education should surely be service to others. Senator Chavez understood that service to others requires inventiveness and creativity. And you remember too that you have been studying and living in the cradle of innovation of the future. And it's California's great engine of entrepreneurship and ingenuity, Silicon Valley. You haven't just been living here and going to school here. This university has contributed to the success of Silicon Valley in a very important way. Hundreds of graduates in engineering today will enter the workforce in Silicon Valley. And here we see Cesar Chavez and all of the social studies graduates here, as well as with engineering and the rest and the sciences that come in together. My favorite story about the engineers and math is a student was in class and the teacher said, it's like first grade, what is one and one? And he said, two. And she said, well, what is two and two? And he said, four. She said, good. He said, not good, perfect. Perfect. And that's what you all are about, achieving what is best and perfect and balanced and makes sense. You have, should have confidence that this university has prepared you, not only what you talked about, which was so beautiful, about knowledge.